mummy is stuffed with grasses, but otherwise naturally preserved. And he has this fabulous feathered headdress and skirt that we think might have been put on him at the time of his death, so maybe he was a beloved pet, maybe he was loved within the group.
From an ancient monkey to a child believed to be more than 6,000 years old, Mummies of the World at the Maryland Science Center is providing details of human and animal history from all over the world.
This is definitely not an ooh exhibition. This is not creepy. This is a way of just seeing inside other people's lives. They have the chance to share with us in their death what their life was like.
Mummies of the World is the largest collection of mummies ever assembled. They come from 20 museums throughout Europe. Dr. Heather Gill Frerking is the director of science and education for the exhibit. She says mummification wasn't limited to Egypt.
Well, we certainly do have some mummies from Egypt. We have wrapped and unwrapped mummies from Egypt, but you'll also see some beautiful animal mummies from around the world. We have crypt mummies from Hungary and from southern Germany. We even have beautiful mummies from South America with long hair and tattoos.
Tattoos like those on the tattooed woman found naturally preserved in Chile. Her markings reveal who she may have been, but a scar from a long ago breast surgery tells much more.
So 700 years ago, they used hot metal to seal that wound. She survived that treatment and lived for a long period of time after it. So you really get to see these mummies as people. We were able to tell their story a little bit from their bodies, and so you really get to understand them as people, who they were, how they lived, the fact that they're just like you and I. We can tell how old they were when they died, whether they were healthy, sometimes what they were eating, and sometimes even their occupation. We have church records for some of these mummies.
And even now, this Hungarian family from the 18th century is helping scientists solve mysteries.
We have church records that tell us the names and date of birth and date of death of these people, and we've even been able to study the type of tuberculosis that they have using pathogen DNA, so we can see how the tuberculosis has changed over time.
There are over 45 mummies and dozens of artifacts, all painstakingly preserved for you.
Because it is a science center, kids will have a few exhibits that they're going to be able to touch. They can get sort of up close and personal with the mummies. This is the last stop on the tour, and the exhibit stays open until January the 20th, so there's still time to come and check it out. Here at the Science Center, Jennifer Franciotti, WBAL-TV 11 News.